All right, look at this crowd, awesome. So welcome everybody, I see some, obviously some familiar faces and this is great, welcome. I see some faces I don't know, so for you, everybody, welcome as well. My name's Dr. Mike Gorman, this is our clinic, welcome to Gorman Optimal Health Solutions. So we've been here for about 10 years and this is my 14th year in practice and just great to have everybody here. This is wonderful. We actually just a few months ago expanded the back area, so this actually was not ours, and we ended up expanding it apparently just in time. So this is wonderful. So great. So I just want to thank everybody for being here. I'm very excited about the alkaline movement and the direction it's going. I've been studying different concepts of alkalinity and alkalizing and different things for probably 20 years. Started back with Tony Robbins years ago. It's made a huge difference for me and my patients and family and friends. And I'm really thrilled to introduce my good friend and mentor, Dr. Howie Cohn, tonight, because just a little bit about our relationship. You know, we had met when I was actually still in school, and everybody kept saying, you've got to go see this doctor. He does this amazing healthcare class. And he gets 50 to 100 people every week, and it's just amazing. And I kept saying, I want to see this, I want to see this. So finally I said, I've got to see this. And in my last semester of school, I actually flew out to California, to where he's from, Newport Beach, and got to see it firsthand. And it was absolutely amazing, 100 people there, and every question that they could possibly throw at him, he answered, and it was very inspiring. So so it's with absolute pleasure, I'm very excited that he's here and he's here to talk to us about this. I can't think of a better person to be talking about that. And hopefully we can actually also see if we can't maybe get him to share a few of his concepts from his healthcare class as well. He's kind of known for his demonstrations. So I think we've got a good crowd. We can put him on the spot a little bit, and I think he can handle it, I'm pretty sure. So I want to give a good welcome to my good friend and mentor, Dr. Howie Cohn. A little bit about how tonight's going to go. For about the first hour, we're going to talk, we're going to answer questions, we're going to do different things, we're going to take a 5-minute break, and then we're going to come back for anybody that wants to hear more after that. So, sorry for that.
Oh, awesome. Hi, everybody.
Hey.
All right, we're going to have some fun tonight. First of all, it's a thrill to be here. Just got off the plane not that long ago, and you know, we talked about coming out here for quite some time. I've known Dr. Gorman, like he said, since he was a student, and it's just been great to see his evolution. And ironically, tomorrow we're speaking at the Institutes for Human,
Human Achievement.
Get that right? We got that slide right when I put that together. Did I say potential on it? It's achievement, right? Did I screw up the slide?
We got it.
Did you check it?
I did.
Okay.
I know better.
So, no, it's been really great. I know that. Just out of interest, how many people are already a patient here or have been here before? That's awesome. And some of you are brand new? Yes, a couple, handful. Well, welcome. You're definitely in an amazing place. And tonight, our goal was really just kind of talk a little bit about this alkaline movement, its evolution. I'll give you a little bit about how we came to that. I have a clinic in Southern California called the Cohn Health Institute. We do a lot of similar things there that is done here. In fact, on the East Coast, Dr. Gorman is definitely one of the go-to physicians out here that we've referred people to for quite a long period of time. And what I was alluding to is tomorrow is he's been an on-staff doc at this amazing health center that people fly in and travel to around the world to go see. So it is a really neat thing, and to see the full circle of having him have me speak there and share a couple of concepts of how it can benefit people to move towards this alkaline movement and this breakthrough discovery of molecular hydrogen. And we'll talk a little bit about that. You saw the fancy video about that as well. So Dr. Gorman also alluded to the health class. At our office at the Cohn Health Institute, we do something called our weekly Wednesday night health workshop. I actually did it last night, and We've done it every week for 25 years.
Wow.
Called the longest running show in Costa Mesa, California. So I'll kind of describe it to you a little bit. Maybe we can turn this into an impromptu hybrid talk tonight if you would like. Basically, when I first started doing that class, I used to get up in front of the room and lecture about what I thought people needed to hear about their own health. And then I realized, wow, I could talk for hours and still not cover anything anyone had personal interest of in the room. And then we adapted it to what we call a question and answer format, where people would just ask questions about what brought them there, and then we'd show them natural ways to heal themselves, and we would do demonstrations to kind of show them how smart their body is, how it was designed to heal itself, using a lot of the concepts and techniques that Dr. Gorman does here at the clinic. It's very wow-ish if you've never seen anything like this before, because a lot of you are already patients here, you see it. However, the first time you saw it, it was pretty wow-ish. You know, it's like the first time you saw a fax machine and like, wait a second, I shoved a piece of paper in here and it came out in another state, and then how did that happen? You know, so right now you're like, whatever, nobody faxes anymore anyway. So dating yourself. So, however, it is that kind of wow factor, so to speak. And so when we look at health, we look at three sides of health. We look at our physical health, our nutritional health, our mental, emotional health. And nutrition has always been a big part. You know, I know that if some people come here, they've probably added a nutritional supplement along the way to their diet. And the definition of a supplement is something that's fills the gap between what we're supposed to be getting in our diet and what we're actually getting in our diet. For some people, that gap is tremendous. It's like the Grand Canyon, right? And some of us are really good eaters, and it's narrow. We just need a couple little things. And in our office at the Cohn Health Institute, we have over 2,000 nutrition products from 100 companies from around the world. So, because we have, like here, many people that come with all kinds of different things. We always wanted to make sure we had exactly what they need when they came. Now, that being said, after 25 years of doing this, there's very simple common denominators that if we can just get people to do a handful of things, so many things would never have to happen to begin with. There's a famous thought about, you know, what's more exciting than having a tumor go away is never having the tumor to begin with, right? So in China, they say don't wait till you're thirsty to dig a well, which means it's a lot easier to stay well than it is to have to get well all the time, so to speak. So So we leaned on nutrition a lot. Now, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the evolution of what we talked about with this with 7.2 and why that was created. In the 90s, I lectured for a decade on our external environment, teaching people that they should filter their air, filter their water, look at what's going in their foods, pay attention to what's starting to happen or what was starting to happen back then with electromagnetic pollution. And because our external environment was affecting us so much, I started to see more and more patients come in where these things, their health issues were related to things that were what we call exogenous from outside their body. But what happened is it went through to the 90s, at the end of the 90s and the first part of the 2000s, it was overwhelming. And we realized it's like drowning. This could not catch up fast enough with the amount of things that were exponentially affecting people. World-class athletes that will come in, and they were sensitive to the craziest things that they never were before. You know, we had people that could not tolerate a gluten anymore. They couldn't tolerate dairy, couldn't tolerate soy, they couldn't tolerate stuff that they lived on for so long, and it was affecting their performance. We had people that, because they were sensitive to the Wi-Fi in their house, to fluoride in the water, to all these different things, and what we realized is that we had to make a shift to strengthening the host, as we say, because it's immeasurable the amount of things that affect everybody every day. So we're looking at what are those common denominators, because when you have a practice like this, when people have been to 10 to 12 doctors, no one's helped them, they finally come, they have the sense that they've been everywhere and done everything. They've not been everywhere and done everything, because if they had, they would have had the result. They've been to a lot of places and done a lot of things. So we wanted to kind of reel that in and give people simple and easy strategies. So when we looked at it, you know, I had a patient of mine that was very successful, ran a very successful nutrition company in the 1990s that did over $1 billion in nutritional sales, educating people on minerals. And he had sold his company, retired, but had always been a patient. And we were looking, he became a father, I became a father, we're looking at this legacy that we're leaving for our children. and not very happy about it. And then we looked at, you know, if we can do anything, he asked me, if you can get everybody, if you can get anybody to take one thing out of these thousands of things, and you only had one, what would you do? And I said, well, if I could get everybody to get everybody to eat raw green foods and like it, that last part, like it, like doing it, then the majority of health conditions would vanish. And he goes, why don't they do it? And I go, well, it's not easy, it's not simple, it's not cost effective, it's not palatable, right? Most people remember the first time they had wheatgrass, because it's the last time they had wheatgrass, right? They just go, I know you said it was good, Dr. Gorman, but I felt like I licked the bottom of my lawnmower, right? And there went your alkaline movement. So it doesn't matter, you know, between wheatgrass and barley grass, that there's more protein per ounce than a steak, more vitamin C than oranges, more vitamin A than carrots. I mean, it doesn't matter if it tastes like garbage, right? You know, if the average human, even, you know, in any town, not just this town, if I got the Krispy Kreme donut over here and I got the head of raw broccoli, the donut will usually win. It's going to win because it's a better consumer experience, at least at the moment. Not 20 minutes later when I'm exhausted, brain fogged, and bloated, but at that moment, my taste buds told me, disregard all that stuff and just go for the donut. So the goal was to figure out a way to do that. So, and there were a couple motivations to doing that. Throughout my first 20 years of practice, cancer, heart disease, and stroke were your number one killers in America, and just heart disease and cancer would just flip back and forth depending on what study you read. But real recently, in the last 5 years, diabetes and obesity are on such a freight train to take over that it's unstoppable now. There was a documentary done called Globesity, The Fat Frontier. And in that documentary, they studied the four most emerging markets, which are India, China, Mexico, Brazil. And in Mexico right now, diabetes is the number one killer. Not cancer, not heart disease, diabetes. Obesity is so out of control that the government is subsidizing people to get lap band surgery. No. Yes, they are. They'll just say, listen, just cut a piece of your stomach out or tie it up. Just stop eating, whatever you do, because you're bankrupting this country. That's how bad it is. So at the same time, I was remembering two things. There was that, and then there was this report put out in the prestigious New England Journal of Medicine that said that it's predicted that the first time in 200 years our present-day children are predicted not to live as long as their parents. And the number one, 200 years, two centuries, number one reason is type 2 diabetes, number two is obesity. And then there was a documentary, I don't know if you've ever seen this one, it was originally called Raw for 30 Days. And it was retitled Simply Raw. Anyone ever see that one? Okay. Couple people. And I'll kind of sum it up for you. Gabriel Cousins, famous medical doctor in the United States, he got a medical team together and wanted to measure what would happen if he took insulin-dependent type 2 diabetics that are morbidly obese. Okay, so we got big people so far out of control with their blood sugar that they have to inject insulin in order to survive. All he did was feed them nothing but raw green foods for 30 days. And here's what happened to everyone who stayed in his program. Within 2 days, 48 hours, everybody who stayed in the program was able to lower their insulin dose that they needed to keep their blood sugar balanced. Within 2 weeks, everyone was off of insulin and losing weight. Wow. Within 4 weeks, everyone was medically released as cured of diabetes. So where's the American Diabetic Association? Come showing up, knocking on the door, giving a big hug, high five, here's the Nobel Prize. Thanks for saving the world's biggest epidemic. Nowhere. Crickets, right? This is way more money in treating diabetes than there ever will be in fixing it or spending the money to educate people on how simple it is to make a change. So again, if it is to be, it's up to we. If we're not responsible for our health, it's going to disappear. Remember, there's only one place to coast, and that's down. So we're either building our health every day or we're losing it. Now, in all fairness, they caught up with somebody who did not get through the program. They actually ran away. She ran off campus, right? So they call up this person, they go, where are you going? What are you doing? These people losing weight, they're holding on to their limbs, they're going to live. How could you leave? And the guy looks at the camera and he said, I'd rather be dead than have to eat like that. And therein lies the human condition. Right? Mark Twain used to say, I know I live 10 years long if I quit smoking, but that would be 10 years without cigarettes. Right? So we live in this culture that if it's not easy, if it's not simple, and if I can't afford it, I'm not going to do it. Because everyone's got to be able to say those four magic words, which are, I can do this. If they can't, they're not going to do it. So, you know, in the world of service, in the world of business, there's a saying called, there's a big paycheck for the people who figure out how to solve big problems, okay? And the wealthiest people in this country are the ones that have figured out how to serve the most and solve the biggest problems for the most people, in most cases. So we took it on to look at that. And the first order of business was to try and figure out how to make greens taste good without screwing them up. You know, because if you heat them, you screw them up. If you add too many things to them, you screw it up. If you process it too much, you screw it up. And so the world didn't need another nutrition company. Didn't need another greens. It didn't definitely need not need another shake. But what it needed was something simple and easy so that everyone can do, whether they're age 2 or 92 and everybody in between, to actually alter their whole state or their health. So whether somebody was just trying to get healthier or somebody was a high-performance athlete trying to improve or to beat out their competition. So we looked at that and we put a program together and we called it 7.2. One of the philosophies we looked at was that what we call the alkaline movement. So we didn't create it, we just advanced it in 7.2. So after dealing and contacting the largest organic manufacturers in the United States and working through tons and tons and tons of formulas, we were able to get it. And the litmus test, no pun intended, was the kids. Is that if a kid will not eat it, then there's no use actually ever bringing it to market. Because that's really the thing. As the twig has bent, so grows the tree. We don't change the culture, give an opportunity for our children to choose something other than Coca-Cola or a Nestle product, then we're screwed. So there's a lot more time, energy, and money spent on things going the other way. You know, whether you know it or not, I mean, Philip Morris, remember them from the tobacco days, are the largest producers of children's food products. Did you know that? Yeah. When you follow the money trail all the way up, that's where it goes. Do you know that these companies, we won't point them out, who make cookies that are, let's say, dark brown on each side with white in the middle, okay? They do these tests where they have what's called fat rooms. It's awesome. It's very honoring. Where they have morbidly obese people that have insatiable appetites already for eating things like cookies and candy and cake and ice cream. And they get them in a room and they measure everything on these people and they get teams of scientists to measure these things and monitor them. And they give them products and they keep tweaking the chemistry and the chemicals that are added to the products to bypass their satiety center. So you just can't eat one chip, right? So you can't say no to cookies. See, you know, God made food a different way, right? If you take a banana, okay? Banana is like a great example of a food because it's got its own, it comes with its own carton, right? The skin. And inside it's protected, and you know, like all good things that are healthy, if it doesn't go bad, it's not good for you, so it eventually will take care of itself and decompose. But when you eat the banana, there are nutrition in there that balance it out to hit a satiety point where you just don't sit down to four bananas. Have you ever actually sat down and had four bananas? No, seriously, I can never eat more than one banana, and that's got to be a small banana. So that's how it is. But I can polish up. I don't know about you all, but if the Girl Scouts come by with those cookies, I have no problem putting one or two boxes down if there's something good on TV, right? So what's the difference? One has been engineered differently. So guys, this is what we deal with on a daily basis. So what I wanted to do first was to figure out a way to make greens taste good. So we did that. You know, behind me are certain products here. I know that Dr. Gorman said a lot of people have tried these. If not, make sure you try them before you go. These greens that we created here are so good you can eat them right out of the container. Container. I am originally from New York. So there it was. Okay. So it was the East Coast, man. Just right back out. Stick around, there'll be some F-bombs. So been in California for a lot of years. They're pented up. It's not as appreciated on the West Coast. You know, here it's like the word the. You just use it as often. Okay? It doesn't have a lot of stigma to it. Out there, people pucker up, especially in Orange County. Okay? Where were we? Greens. So, 100% organic. Very important, prepared to raw standards. Raw means because if you heat it, you destroy the enzymes that are in it. Very important thing about this product. What makes it taste good is a Chinese herb called Lohan Guo, which is Lohan berry, which is really 100 times sweeter than sugar, but it's a berry. And there's some other little secret things in here that actually we found that after thousands of tests, that the organic flavor of raspberry and green apple will successfully block the not so yummy flavor of wheatgrass and barley grass. So that is magic. So anybody who does greens and tries these, freak out. Freak out. They're rapidly known. We're at the Natural Products Expo, where there are 77,000 people go on the West Coast. And one of the big blogger came up to me and said, "Oh, you're from 7.2. He goes, "You guys have the best tasting greens in the industry," which is big since there was probably about 70 booths of greens at this event. So, and again, organic, like we said, and everything dissolves completely in water. It's so good you can eat it right out of the container. A lot of athletes on this product have actually now, 7.2 has been in business about 3.5 years. We have, I just found out, I'm so thrilled because I'm a big hockey fan. We have about 40 NHL hockey players that now take our greens and this other product called Recovery that I'll tell you about. So I don't know if there's any flyers. They're kind of leaking out the names to me. So nobody wants to tell me. Professionally, if anyone deals with professional athletes, it's a different animal. They don't want to tell. You know, if you're excited, you see a good movie, you tell your friends, you go to a good restaurant, you tell everybody. If you talk to a professional athlete and they find something they love, they'll tell anybody. They don't want anybody to know, especially from the elite high school level to college, because they don't want, they got to lose the edge, and if someone's going to take their spot if they discover their thing. So when I first heard it, I'm like, seriously? And then like 5 strength and conditioning coaches told me, oh yeah. It's an issue. So so we started with the greens. There's also greens in, it's not up here, but we have greens in capsules as well, because some people just don't like powder, and the most important thing is to get those greens into people. There's nothing that sweetens them in the capsules. The capsules are the straight organic raw greens, so you can just swallow them on the go. When I take my kids, we go out to a restaurant, and we're going to have like something that's, let's say, acidic, you know, like pizza or something, you know, we're like, listen, we'll just make sure they always pop a couple of green caps with them. Then try and shove, because we got a place. There are places that just have no vegetables. It's, you know, they don't have them. So the next thing we did is we looked at shake. Why do we do this? We had to deal with breakfast, right? We're in America. Let's do all-American breakfast. So again, with food, let's just back up for a second. Foods are either acid or alkaline. And acid foods aren't necessarily all bad. It's just that 95% of our plate every day is acidic foods and not so much alkaline. Take breakfast. The breakfast is the most notorious, okay? Let's say you went to a diner for breakfast, okay, and you ordered the all-American breakfast. So, and you had the acidic eggs with the acidic bacon, the acidic sausage, the acidic ham, and the acidic French toast, and the acidic pancakes with the acidic waffles, with the acidic syrup, with the acidic coffee, the acidic milk, the acidic sugar in there as well, and the acidic butter floating on top. Yet, there was a tiny piece of alkalinity that made it on that Grand Slam breakfast, right? And it was that very tired, lonely piece of parsley that was on, you know it, that little sprig all alone by itself in the acidic world. And then we get it, right? What do? We look at this, yes, with disdain. We look at it with disdain, like at the food server. how dare you mock up this beautiful artwork of a breakfast with this weed? We just slap it off. How could you? It's a 5,000-year-old herb called the Wand of Heaven by cultures for thousands of years. Not anymore. Not at the Denny's. So, anyway. So, everything, all these things, shake and the greens, are everything we want them to be free of. Gluten-free, dairy-free, soy-free, whey-free, nut-free, nightshade-free. All the different things that are what we call pro-inflammatory that people don't even know they're allergic to or sensitive to or might be slowing down their performance or their digestion or their thought process or whatever, okay? So, again, so good to eat out of the container. My daughter, my seven-year-old, eats out of the container. She thinks it's pancake mix. And you can do anything with it. Both of these you can take. Most people take two scoops of this, one scoop of this. Everything's designed to last for a month because we're trying to create a lifestyle habit of people doing this. They can mix together. They completely dissolve in water. You don't need a Nutribullet or a very expensive blender, although you can make them yummy creations with them. And time and energy. So this is real fast food. You can take your shakes, your greens, mix them up, and drink them faster than you can get your family through the drive-thru. We've actually timed it. Somebody did one on YouTube. I said that in a couple lectures, and someone goes, "Hey, we're here in Boise, Idaho. We're going to time what Dr. Cohn said." And they're sitting outside of McDonald's, and people on their watch. Here it goes. The family get the watch, and they're mixing their shake and greens in the car. It's hysterical. So, and it did. It actually, I that's the first time when I really, in theory, it should be. But it did, which was really cool to see. So, real fast food. They come. These all come in travel packets. Easy. To go packets, I just
spill.
Okay, so we have a program called Health Made Simple. Why? Because it's confusing health, or what it is or what it isn't. People think I'm healthy if I don't have symptoms, right? So you ask people, are you healthy? Yeah, how you doing? I'm good, but you know, if I go to Dr. Gorman's office and gives me this intake form, I check off 20 boxes of things that are bugging me. You just tell me you're good. There's 20 things wrong. Oh, those are normal. They're not normal, they're common. Normal is a setting on a washing machine. It's not normal to have knee pain. It's not normal to have digestive disturbance. It's not normal to get bloated after I eat a certain thing. It's not normal to have headaches. Those are common. They're not normal. So we wanted to make it so simple. So we have our shakes and greens in the morning. That's step one. It's three steps, okay? We're going to jump to the third step, and I'll come back to the second step. Doesn't matter what I say here tonight, with the next 24 hours, we're going to go out and eat something acidic. I'm in Pennsylvania. I haven't been out here in a while. I'm for sure going to eat a cheesesteak somewhere before I go. It's just like not fair not to. So I'm saving it. So we're going to do it. Whatever it is, whether it's my cup of coffee or it's my comfort food, or it's that ice cream, or it's that thing that, you know, all my whatever it is, we're going to eat it. So rather than be in denial, rather than come and lie to Dr. Gorman and say, no, I don't know why my knee hurts, and he goes, well, I'm testing it, and this is something you ate. So rather than do that, it's this philosophy is, if you do the crime, you do the time, okay? If you're going to eat it, you can't be denying that it's not affecting your body. So what happens is, let's say I go out and I have a cheeseburger with a blooming onion and a beer, okay? Super sick, right? So already my body's immediately in this fight or flight reaction. The acid levels are off. It's firing like adrenal hormones. I'm already starting to store the acid as fat. The next thing it does, it pulls oxygen from my tissues to balance out the acid. That's usually gonna be enough, not gonna be enough, because I threw the onion thing in there. So now it's going to actually start to pull calcium from my bones, magnesium from my heart, potassium from adrenals and other places. It's gonna start to leach my body of minerals. And we do this every day, all day long, okay? So what we have in our alkaline booster, it puts all those things back. That's what it does. All your alkaline minerals back in the easy to swallow capsule. All my kids take these before they go to bed. We always kid around, we say when we go out at night, we say, how big a booster night was it, right? So if tomorrow we're going to some banquet, right? So there's going to probably be cocktails, you know? So we're going to take more boosters. Normally people take four before they go to bed. Younger kids take two or three. I've taken 10 at one time. So athletes, a lot of athletes take boosters. You know, this really delivers what like a Gatorade thinks you should have but doesn't, but they market you should. So this really delivers all the alkaline minerals back, helps oxygenate the system. And so if anybody has digestive disturbances, it helps balance that out. If someone doesn't sleep well at night, this is going to be their new friend. We have them take them before they go to bed because, you know, most people in this country, you know, if you go to Europe, the big meals during the day, this country, dinners are a big meal. You know, if you ate a steak, it takes 14 hours to digest that. It's 14 hours that dead body's right, dead cow is rotting in there. Trying to break down. I know, nice visceral description. And it's forming all kinds of gas. So rather than you sit in an acidic pool while you sleep and wondering why I have reflux and why I don't sleep well, it's easy to take this before to bed and go, I slept like a baby since I took those alkaline boosters. The college students have petitioned us multiple times to rename it as Hangover Helper. I'll let you figure out what that does. So we don't, because we're a health company, the whole goal is not to promote alcohol consumption. 7.2 is expanded in over 16 different countries where they get these products now. This is one of the reasons. The product I'll talk about next is the main reason. There's such a thing since brought up the alcohol thing. If you know, it's very most common in the Asian communities. Whether you know it or not, half the world is Asian of some sort. And half of them have something, which is a quarter of the planet, they call Asian flush or Asian glow, which means if they have a sip of alcohol, doesn't matter if it's beer, wine, sake, whatever it is, they get a red flushing reaction throughout their body. Some people get so sick they vomit. Okay, very embarrassing thing for such a proud culture who can't even have a sip of something to celebrate or whatever. So it turns out, that's not why this was created, but this gets rid of that issue for them. As far as a market, it's quite huge. I asked one of our colleagues, Dr. Gorman's of mine, Ray Jin, who is Asian, and used to be a research molecular biologist, like, can you see if you can validate this for us? And he did, and he shot a video, they put a website up called AsianFlushGone.com. We do absolutely nothing with it. It's just out there, because that's not the mission. The mission is really to give people an opportunity to actually be healthy and not dependent on a crippled system and a lie that says that if they don't have symptoms, they're healthy. Our goal is to, again, like we talked about in the beginning, it's so much better not to have to fix or cure yourself from something. It's so much better to not have it to begin with. And our goal is to really wag that dog, and that has to happen with younger children and people realizing that they can do it. Okay. So this is we call it actually on the label, it says nicknamed the Hall Pass. Obviously, you can figure it out. Now, the next thing was this. Now this product is called Recovery. When we first started, it was not called Recovery. It was called Coffee Drops, which is a silly name. So because all I was trying to do when we started this thing, because the hardest thing in the United States that got everybody was their cup of coffee or two or three or 12 in the morning, okay? And that started their day very acidic. And we wanted to figure out how to alkalize coffee. There was a theory out there by Dr. Robert Young, who wrote the PH Miracle books, planted the seed in my head, said he was working out a formula to do it. I still don't think he ever did, but we got very lucky. I met a scientist from Serbia who was investigating something called molecular hydrogen. I didn't know really much about that. I knew from alkaline water machines that alkalized your water would release a little molecular hydrogen, and that's all I really knew. I didn't know how deep that rabbit hole went in healthcare. And he would laugh at me because he goes, listen, you can use this and it will alkalize your coffee. But the real thing is it is a selective antioxidant and a super anti-inflammatory. So, and when I looked at it, I realized there were 400 peer-reviewed studies already on molecular hydrogen for everything you could possibly think you could imagine, from heart disease to Alzheimer's to Parkinson's to tremendous stuff in the athletic world. So we started to investigate this, and then while I was giving these people this stuff, it was in a different form, it would dissolve kind of almost all the way in your coffee. all these people would come up to me and say, you know, I've had pain in my knee for years, and I took your coffee drops, and it doesn't hurt. Why is that? And so, and then it advanced to people that had the most horrific RSD or fibromyalgic pain, where they're looking at pictures of their kids, not to just blow their brains out because they are in level 12 out of 10 pain. And they said I would just keep taking these and it would eventually go away. So we had a look at that, and we did, but unfortunately we live in a very interesting world. We are, myself, Dr. Gorman, in more of a holistic natural healthcare world. We live in an allopathic medical world where medicine and really pharmaceutical companies, who they use medical doctors to have what's called a cultural authority. So we think that no matter what they say, it must be right. And it's not always that way, so to speak. So because of that, there's a lot of agencies that won't let you say anything about anything in this country. So although since we've gone to Australia and New Zealand, the TGA, which is their FDA, is worse. Health Canada, even worse. So the interesting process, what I won't bore you with. So this guy, recovery, what does it do? It helps you recover from what? Just about anything. Now what we did, because we're not even allowed to say it will get rid of your pain, even though that's was probably the biggest thing in the beginning people would take it for, or all these other things that it did. We do every Wednesday night, every Tuesday night, I do a weekly wellness call, and people call them from around the world, with all these things that are happening with their health from these products. It is staggering. I've done it for 3.5 years now, and the stories are unbelievable. They're completely unbelievable. Most of our time and effort has been in the field of athletics out of the gate with this product, only because nobody bothers you when you're actually testing athletes, believe it or not. So we've been able to measure some things that you would measure when you're looking at things like cancer or heart disease, but we've been able to measure on athletes. Now, when athletes take this before they work out or exercise, especially if there are athletes that can measure themselves, like how much they can lift, how fast they can run, their VO2, all these different things that they're measuring, probably about 85 to 90% of the time they'll PR, which is they'll break their own personal record. Now, when I heard that in the beginning, I understood it, but I wouldn't believe it until I met a lot of different athletes that did that. And in almost every sport, there's over 30 different sports right now, because we're in a lot of different countries. You know, we have like the 4 sports here, you know, but there's Aussie rules football, and there's rugby, and there's cricket, and there's all these, like, you know, there's all these different martial art, you know, sports, and golf, and we have a lot of senior golfers. You know, I had lunch a few months ago with Bernard Langer and Fred Funk, because they love these products. So all the different spectrums, like talked about the hockey players, cyclists. I was in the Czech Republic, and then we did a talk in Slovakia, and there was a cyclist who got kicked off the tour in 2002 for blood doping. Turns out 100% of everybody blood dopes, so there was really just one famous guy that got, you know, blasted in the papers. But this guy has been out of the sport, and he says, since I've been on this product, and he measures everything, he goes, my numbers are the same as if I'm doping. It is a big, big, big deal. Big deal. A lot of track coaches in California, the track coach, and in Boise, there's a Boise State coach that has a lot of their track and field people that use this product. On both ends, the original study we did was the 18% reduction in lactic acid, so when you actually take it, I'm not sore after, but the performance ahead of time. And the thing that put it over the edge for us were in Canada, there was some steeplechase race horses that we use this product with. We actually created a bigger tablet for them, and these horses took this product. 9 out of 9 horses broke their own records, and 2 were injured when they broke it. So needless to say, when people spend millions of dollars on a horse, and horses are great, they're like dogs, they're not like skeptical, they're not like, oh, you're pushing my paw down harder with a muscle, you know? You're not, you know, they don't got any of that going on. You know, they're like, oh, this is one of those companies, I'm gonna trot off, you know? I have it on the plate too, though. So, in any event, it's crazy. So what people do is they get up in the morning, have their shaky grease, they take recovery during the day, and they'll take their alkaline booster before they go to bed. It's that simple. Now, as it turns out, how human physiology works, another serendipitous thing, which we kind of knew anyway, but we promote it in the beginning, was that if you eat alkaline foods, your body emulsifies fat more efficiently. When you eat acid foods, your body goes in that fight or flight response and it stores fat. It's really that simple. That's why you really don't see, you know, 300-pound vegans too often, right? Unless they're just living on pasta and candy bars. No, I'm a vegan. Pasta and candy bars. No meat. Look at me. No bone density. You know. Anyway, hysterical. There's a couple floating through here. So, anyway. So, and it turns out, if you know, there's a saying called first you dance, change the music. First you dance, then change the music. Yeah. The world is not Googling health. They're not. They're Googling weight loss, fat, how do I get lose 5 pounds for the wedding on Friday, you know, whatever. That's what they're doing. So we created a program which is exactly the same. Nothing's changed except you take another shaving greens during the day, either at lunch or dinner. That's it. We created a little trial pack here, which amazingly has gotten tens of thousands of people to 7.2 and using these products, which you would never imagine. So, pretty little pack, 3-day trial pack. The average person loses 3 to 5 pounds in 3 days. Yes, they do. So, let's see what's inside. Little tracker, this little brochure. Everything's that you see in the bottles are in travel packets. So you have shakes and greens for 3 days, alkaline booster for 3 days, and recovery for 3 days. And the best part of this is not what happens throughout those first 3 days. The best part is day 4, when they run out. Because, you know, a lot of times we're just so numb with our day-to-day running from here to there. And then we don't notice the change that much all the time. Except, like, hey, I guess I was feeling good because I'm back to feeling like crap on day 4 because I ran out. Okay? So, there you have it. And it's a convenient way, like, if you want your friends to try it because you tried it and you love it and you don't want them to get a whole tub of something. Try it for 3 days. It's like, you know, it's like anything else. It's like ladies who walk by the in the mall and there's this beautiful dress on the mannequin. What do? You go, I'm going to try that dress on. Now, sometimes you try it on and it looks better on me than it looked on the mannequin. Sometimes I tried it on and it was clearly for the mannequin, right? It didn't highlight what I wanted it to highlight. It did the opposite, right? So like anything else, there's no 100% for everything. There's a lot of time and energy making this program so that the majority of everybody, or most people, can actually do this and it'll work for them in a way. And then what they do is, like we do here, is fill the gaps with those other little things that somebody might need. But like in our profession, in our colleagues, where we've been over the last decades, is that we're so busy fixing all these wild things that people come in with, that we miss these basics, and there's a lot, this just basic education that people are missing. And it turns out, had they been doing it, they never would have needed to be here, but they could come here to advance their health rather than having to regain it, okay? So that is 7.2, that is our program. It's grown very popular around the world, Korea, other places. The U.S. is a little slower only because we're just inundated with so much, right? I watched Dr. Oz, and every show, there's one more supplement I can't live without, and there's science behind it, and I'm watching 5 days a week, so I got 5 new things coming. At the end of the year, 5 times 20 times, I got 200 products in my cabinet that Dr. Oz said I couldn't live without, right? So it's just, it's insane, it's crazy making, and it's not to say that these things all don't have value, but at the end of the day, there are very simple things that were put here for us to be healthy and to advance our health. So that's what we do here. I still have 2,000 products in my office. These are just used more so that people don't have to use more of other things. Okay, so we are very excited to be here because really the East Coast, other than like, there are more people in the Tongan community of New Zealand that know about 7.2 than there are in Pennsylvania. So for those people who know when a good thing comes to town and you're the first who got to tell people about it, it's a good thing. So, and one more word about acid, and then we'll maybe do some Q&A, or if you want to do some demos or something, we can do that. So, is that at the end of the day, even all the stuff we talked about health, what you see here, you know, for those of you who've been here and had things done like NET or had emotions treated with lasers and whatnot, turns out that stress, emotional stress, is our greatest acidifier, right? And the top two reasons for stress, at least in this country, are relationship stress, not just this country, every country, relationship stress and financial stress. And when you interview people, you talk to therapists, the number one thing couples argue over is finances. So at the end of the day, it's a big issue for a lot of people. So one of the things we looked at was really to create the advance, this alkaline movement, was to really create a program that for as people educate people about it, they can also handle that part of their life. Because there's certain models of health and there's certain models of wealth or finances the same way, which either you gotta feed a system that so that it works and work on the root of the issue, or you're treating the affect. In the world of business, you know, the Hollywood entertainers have figured out that, sports athletes have figured out that. At the end of the day, everybody trades time for money, but if you have something that you can do where you can educate somebody about something and you can get rewarded for it, it's like what we get to do every day. You know, by the person who, the first chiropractor I ever met when I was 16, he was the most excited person I ever met in my life. I had never seen anybody that loved what they did more. I've never been to a chiropractor. I didn't know what they did. And the day I met him at my career day of all places in school, I decided I was going to be a chiropractor long before I knew what he did. When you hear somebody and you feel them and they're so excited and they say that they would pay to do what they do, rarely do you meet people like that. And when you see what he was doing, and you know, then it was very simple. All we had to do was adjust somebody and they would just get better. Now, because of all the things that affect us, if we don't feed the system, there's just not enough nutrition for it to respond the same way, which is why it's such a big thing. And with the emotional stressors that people are affected by, if we don't relieve those things or we don't have tools and strategies to do that, it's really hard to function and just thrive in this world. So that's kind of what happens here. For those of you who are brand new here and have not partaken, for those of you who are preaching to the choir or maybe reminding you of the obvious, and although Dr. Gorman recommends a lot of things nutrition, I know for the last year he's been using these products and had a lot of results, and I'm sure there are people in this room that have had a lot of good results on these products and using those products. So we can do anything right now. I know that what we're going to, if anyone has any burning questions, I'll be happy to answer them, or if you want me to kind of segue to if somebody wants to see. We can do anything. We get you do this on these guys all the time. Most of you guys see Dr. Gorman, correct? And yeah, have had kinesiological testing done and things cleared out and things balanced out. Or
why don't we start with, do whatever we start with burning questions?
Unless there's somebody who's like, well, I haven't, or I don't know, or he does all this stuff to me and I have no idea what he's doing. Can you imagine? Goes up, it goes down, he's never explained a damn thing to me. Just talking with this person, that table with that person.
I have a burning question.
Yes.
Why don't we answer some questions, and if you can do a demo as part of the answer, that might also work.
Sure.
All right.
I have a burning question.
Yes.
What's the name? Why 7.2?
7.2 is an ideal pH. So, you know, 7 is neutral, and really the only constant is your blood. Your blood should be 7.365, but that's just not really a cool name for a company. And, so, Dr. Robert Young, who wrote the pH Miracle book series, who's like, you know, Tony Robbins, paraded him around for a decade, educating people about alkalinity. He, in one of his books, he said the ideal pH for someone to be healthy is 7.2 to 7.4. In his pH Miracle book for weight loss, he said if someone's going to really function the way they want to, they need to be at least 6.8 to 7.2. So that sweet spot was 7.2. So that's why I went with 7.2. Yes?
What effect does it have on medications that are prescribed, such as Coumadin?
Good question. So there are no necessary, like all the things that you see here, they're in theory, in reality, let's do a reality and then we say what people will caution you on. Reality, there's nothing in here that will interfere with Coumadin. However, if I go to my cardiologist and I'm on Coumadin, warfarin, they're gonna say, don't eat anything green, right? Because it thins your blood, okay? But that's why I'm taking the warfarin. So yet, if I was taking the greens all the time, I might not need the warfarin. So we never tell anybody not to take a medication that some doctors told them. What we have them do is, because anybody on warfarin anyway, Coumadin, they're monitoring their prothrombin time. Not maybe every day, but when they go every other week or once a month, depending. So we just wouldn't say that, we just make sure they don't just start with three scoops of greens or anything. They would start with like one capsule of green caps, or they would do a third of a scoop of greens, and they would do that for between when they started and when they get their prothrombin time done. Now what they're usually going to see, what's funny is that most of the people that are holistically oriented, they don't say anything. So they just wait for their doctor to say something and go, oh, look at that, it's changing. He goes, I don't think you need as much Coumadin. And then you do it for another month and they go, oh, it's getting better. Let's, I think we're going to be able to cut your dose in half. And the funny thing is that I don't know why it's going down. So the third time, most of it happen all the time. And they go, oh, well, I'm taking these. He goes, what are you doing? Because it's dropped dramatically and you don't need as much Coumadin. And he goes, well, I've been taking these green products. Oh, no, you've got to get off those. You can't. So philosophically and ethically, there are issues there. So that's the reality. But the dance is that it's completely fine. We always say if someone's on blood thinners that they consult their doctor and they would just start with a little bit.
Well, would you have to have all these products, or can you just have a single product?
You can have a single product.
In my case, yeah. I have to maintain this blood thing between 2 and 3.
Right.
So ideally it's 2.5.
Right.
And they will adjust, but for the most part, I mean, I'm taking my own INR.
Okay.
Because the little machine.
Yeah, yeah.
And I phone it in, and he adjusts it if it goes above or below.
Right.
Okay. Now, it does affect me with a salad. I mean, just that I can watch it jump.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So that's what I worry about.
Right. Then we would start you, then there's a couple of things. I mean, I would talk to Dr. Gorman. In my community, I have more of a holistically bent cardiologist as well as a general practitioner. I use the GP more often because he's actually brilliant, written nutrition books. And depending on where every person's their own individual, because a lot of times I'll have somebody come in and go, I'd like to think that I might not need this for the rest of my life. So I would send them to a different medical professional to evaluate that,
right.
Give them an option, because 99 out of 100 will say, no, you need it for the rest of your life because you had XYZ procedure. Does that make sense? And,
well, absolutely. But I'm as old as dirt. So,
so that's funny.
I'm going to be on it the rest of my life.
Right.
What I worry about is, what kind of a diet goes along with this? Because, you know, man can't live by 7.2
greens alone. Right.
Well,
you know, what it does, it allows you, what this does is that it allows you to eat more sensibly, and it also allows you not to eat what you want. You can, but the damaging effects of just doing what you've always done to get where you've gotten is dampened. I mean, it doesn't affect you as much. So what you do find, though, is once you introduce these things, you start feeling good, you have less of a craving for that candy bar, that ice cream before I go to bed, those things that were working against you all along.
But, you know, sensibility just goes so far. And there's no sheet that you can hand out that says, well, this is sensible food.
Right.
So we're used to so many products.
Right.
And it's being advertised to us all the time. So, I send my wife back out, you know.
Right.
Grocery stores,
right?
Comes back. I eat.
Yeah,
I eat the box.
There are rules to eating. You know,
no products are good.
Yeah,
that's it.
You know, there's certain things. If it doesn't go bad, it's not good for you. Stay in the outside aisles. White ain't right. You know, there's certain things that you know, but that are manageable. You're better off going to a Whole Foods if you're going to buy something in a bag or a box or a can than you would going to. What's out here now? What do you guys got?
Giant.
Yeah.
ShopRite.
Oh, ShopRite, all those, I remember ShopRite. All those places. Yeah, so here's what you do, the best, you know, like these guys have an in-house nutritionist that can guide you and tailor it for you personally, you know. To me, it just depends. You know, I have a shake and a greens in the morning almost every day, but not every day. Sometimes I'm running around, I'll have it again at lunch, or if I'm going to play hockey at night, which I do, I'll have it before I go play. Instead, it's because I don't want to eat a big meal. But they'll eat other things. Now, when I shop, everything's at Whole Foods or a place called Mother's that we get, so everything's organic and stuff. But I will eat out and do other things. So it allows me to do those things and have less effect. So I know if I'm going to eat a lot of junk, I'm going to take some extra boosters. If I'm going to do some things that are more physically damaging to me, I'm going to take more recovery. And if I do some things where that just, it was clearly like there was nothing green around, I'm going to have more green. That's really the rule of thumb.
Where do fruits fit in?
Fruits are great. They're, you know, we're trying to keep people more towards low glycemic fruits than the higher ones, depending on what is going on with their health. Nothing is more impactful in the body than raw green foods, though, as far as nutritional density, protein content, everything. You know, so, but they're not as yummy. So
you can't be a vegan either.
Well, you can, but it's, you know, it's just no fun. You have less friends.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I've done it all for years just to make sure I knew what it was. I mean, from vegan to macrobiotic to vegetarian to paleo to all of those, any kind of diet that's legit. Now, 90% of them are just copycat diets, but one that any new genre of ways of thinking or eating, I'm going to do it so I can have the experience of it, so I can comment to it rather than just be arrogant and say, oh, I don't like. You know, people, unfortunately, notoriously are down on what they're not up on. So, yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem. Yes?
Me?
Yes?
Do you have any experience with folks that tend to produce kidney stones?
As far as what gets rid of them, or?
The greens. I mean, does it tend to produce stones? Or?
No, I haven't found, after 3.5, really now 4 years of using this, I have not seen that. I've seen people caution people to certain things. But, you know, there's usually what it is, it's find out that the greens are not raw, and we'll find out that they also use other things. One other thing about these greens is that a lot of greens products, if you go to like to a Whole Foods, they try to be all things to all people. And so we modeled more like the Ann Wigmore, beginning wheatgrass, queen of wheatgrass, to Robert Young, who very anal about not corrupting it. If you notice, there's no sea greens in it. There's no spirulina, no chlorella, no cilantro, none of these, none of these algaes, because not that they're bad, but they're so detoxifying. So we're trying to create a product that children can use all the time, that seniors can use that are on medications, that everybody can use that, and if they wanted to add that later, they can do that themselves. And, you know, I live on the West Coast, and unfortunately, all of the West, the Pacific Ocean, is now a glowing Fukushima cesspool. So, believe it or not. So, I mean, there's
it's all the stuff from Fukushima.
From Fukushima, the tsunami. Every fish has measurable levels of radiation in it now. Mm-hmm. Everything, all those great sushi places. Yeah, it's very tragic. You know, the media only reports on what they report on. You know, but there are other information out there that's staggering. It's very sad. Anyway, who knows? Maybe I'm back up in the East Coast. Maybe take a room back over there and hang out at the Gorman Clinic for a while. So, yes.
Can you take too much of the recovery?
You take too much of anything. But really not. I've given, you know, like...
It's not even good,
but... Yeah, no. Yeah, I've given people up to 36 in a day.
Wow.
Yeah, but that person, you know, they blew up their knee, you know, they blew out a meniscus and it was swollen to 6 times its size. Mm-hmm. So, but they were able to actually move it, and you see the swelling come down. If I don't have my phone on me, but I'll show you a picture of a woman from Korea who went through a bottle in 3 days. She took 30 a day for 3 days because she fell down a mountain and face first, and just face road rashed herself, and you can see a transformation on the third day. It's maybe mildly red, like it, because you see how your body can actually heal from the inside out. Hydrogen, this is molecular hydrogen. What's this? This product, when you bring a product to market, you dream of having one element. If you have, but there's three categories. If you have all three, it's going to be a $1 billion product, which it will be. This is a number one is it patented or not, which means can anybody copy it? So there's a patent on this, so it can't be copied. Number two is it a category creator? I mean, is it one more thing? Is it one more shake? Is it one more juice? Is it this? It's a category creator. Nobody has a molecular hydrogen product that releases nanobubble sized gas. Nobody. No one. It goes right inside the mitochondria of your cell. That's what we're talking about tomorrow at this institute, okay? Nobody. Number three is an impact product. You're going to feel it right away when you take it. You feel it. You know you take it. If you have pain anywhere, you're going to know you take it. You're going to know. And you're like, I'm always be on that. So it's got all three to it, you know. There are gyms or fitness studios around the world that's their thing. Yeah. So the answer is no. There, it's in a base of a little bit of calcium magnesium. The worst thing that'll ever happen is you'll have a loose stool. But that's like 1 in 100. Yeah. Yeah. Now, the only thing we say about this is what a selective antioxidant is, the best analogy is it's like fire is good or bad, depending on what kind of fire it is. Like, so if your house is burning down, that's probably not a good fire. You want to put that out. That would be like cancerous cells metastasizing, okay? But a selective antioxidant is also a signaling molecule. It tells your body what's going on so it can run more efficiently and not what we call rust. So it's like anti-aging kind of concept. So in the house, you want the pilot light lit in your stove so you can cook. You like that fireplace on. You just don't want the house to burn down or a forest fire. Does that make sense? So analogously, that's actually how it works in the body. Okay? So, and the fact that it's a gas, it goes everywhere within seconds, like ozone does or like oxygen does or something like that. When you take an herb, it takes 20 minutes to get digested, or a supplement, or even a homeopathic remedy will have an effect faster, but not as fast as that.
I guess that's kind of what I was wondering, if it was homeopathic.
No, it's not. Homeopathy is a different model. This is like you, it's just, as soon as it hits your stomach acid, it releases that. Or actually, as soon as it's your saliva. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Do you have a question?
Yes.
Somebody
at my church, unfortunately, is suffering from cancer. And they're doing chemo, and the chemo was killing them. Surprise, surprise! They said he could take the chemo, and then he can't breathe.
Right.
So I was just wondering, you know, if I can figure out a way to convince him to take it. I mean, would that help him?
Well, legally, I can't say you can't say any things are used to treat anything.
Right, exactly. I'm just saying, would he notice any, you know, like you were saying? I mean,
well, everybody notices stuff. It just depends what stuff is happening for each person. The only thing we say if someone's on chemotherapy is that we don't, and again, this is like the Coumadin recommendation. It's more of a cover your ass kind of statement. We don't recommend because this is such an effective, it'll also be a little bit of a heat-seeking missile for poisons in your system. And chemotherapy, by definition, is a poison. It's trying to poison a piece of your body before it poisons the whole thing. That's really the philosophy of how it works. So the reality is on chemo day, and ideally day before and day after, we don't recommend they take it, but they can take it in between. Does that make sense? So, you know, Otto Warburg got a Nobel Prize for talking in 1930-something. Talking about how, you know, cancer cells cannot live in an oxygenated alkaline environment. So, I mean, everybody beats the crap out of that statement. You're just, you know, the thing is, what you want to do is you want to stack the cards in your favor. If you went and Googled people going on an alkaline diet or a raw green diet, or, you know, go down to below the border, because that's where doctors go if they want to actually do real health care, they have to leave the country because they're ostracized. And most of that's the diet everyone's on. They're on a raw food, vegan diet in 90% of those clinics. So, except it's miserable. So we have clinics that also use these products, and when they release people back into the wild, right, back into their life after they get better, they just don't want to, not everyone wants to keep juicing their wheatgrass 8 ounces a day. So they, you know, they use our product. That help? Yeah.
In a professional setting, recommending these products to adolescents, to parents, things like that, what steps, you know, do you go through? Because you can't treat anything.
No, you can't.
And making food recommendations is not really necessarily in the scope of a trainer or
correct
strength coach. I mean, we always say, hey, you might not want to do that one, or you might want to try X, Y, or Z.
Right.
So it kind of walked that line between being a nutritionist and
most
helping people.
Most of them do. Like the guys that are working with the guys in the NHL, they also have nutrition degrees, so that's what gets them through that.
Right.
The but a lot of the high school coaches we deal with, they third party it. They say, listen, they'll talk to the parent and say, listen, I go, we have a lot of people in the running world that take this product. They disclaim it right off the bat. I can't recommend that you take something. I am not a doctor, but I've seen a lot of great results, or I've heard a lot of great results. And so a lot of times they'll give them like a packet, like a little packet, mm-hmm. and they'll say, hey, you want to, you know, Mary's doing hurdles today. We know exactly your time. Want to do a little experiment. It's completely safe. It's calcium, magnesium. You just want to see if she took them beforehand, would she run faster? And then what happens is, like, when I meet somebody, like, if you look like you're in shape, so it's probably your industry, I would hook you up with some of the strength and conditioning coaches, or some of the guys that are chiros that work with the track people, or, you know, some of the people out of Boise State, and I can just give you the email address and say, here's what I'm looking to do, what do you recommend, what have you seen, you know, so you guys can talk shop and do that, and I could share with you that kind of, but that's what it, we just third, it's just third party,
right,
you know what I mean, and it's always in their choice of what they do. However, I will tell you, in Southern California, there's a lot of schools where those coaches, they're great stories of people that barely would qualify that are now in the top, you know, and there was one girl who beat, she PR'd and beat the number one girl on the team, and she's never done, she's not even in her class, and that was the difference maker. So, you know, we all have these reserves that we don't tap for so many different reasons,
right.
You know, I mean, there's we talked about the importance of not, it's just as much what's in it as what's not in it. You know, if you know anything about tennis, why am I spacing on his name? The Serbian,
Djokovic,
right? He was a phenomenal tennis player, but was sick as a dog. In fact, his colleagues make fun of him all the time. And he had this ultimate moment where he passed out on a court and he could not finish the match. And he had a nutritionist that said, listen, I think you're gluten intolerant. You got to get off gluten. And it turned out, I think it was actually celiac. I think it was that bad. So he completely got off of gluten. The guy won 45 straight matches. I forgot, 4 grand slams. And now they call it the Djokovic diet, you know, which is really a gluten-free diet. The irony is, his parents own the largest chain of pizzerias in Serbia. That's what he grew up on.
Right.
And now, believe it or not, they have the largest gluten-free pizzeria chain in all of Serbia. So, I mean, that guy did more for that gluten-free awareness than just about anybody. I'll tell you one more story on that and how bad. Listen, wheat 100 years ago is not like wheat today. It's a completely different animal. You know, if you go to Europe and you go to have a cafe in Florence, Italy, yes, that pasta has less gluten in it than ours does. So it's not your illusion that you're not as bloated when you went on that cruise and went and ate in that cafe. It's a reality. But here it's just a mess. And there was a case study done on somebody who had ALS, Lou Gehrig's disease, you know, where it's just no cure for that, and wheelchair bound, and, you know, so they did an MRI on the guy, and they see the lesions in his head and on the MRI. Someone had the infinite wisdom to test him to see if he was gluten intolerant. They tested him, and he said, yes, you are. You actually have celiac disease. They get the guy off of wheat, and you start to see the lesions shrink in his brain. And the kicker is that Lou Gehrig was the very first athlete put on a Wheaties box. So these scientists are like, holy crap. They go, ALS might be a form of gluten intolerance, gluten sensitivity, or celiac disease, and no one ever looks at how bad it is. So these athletes, you know, these, you know, 20 years ago, I would stand in the line beside basketball players on the airport, you know, at the McDonald's. Now it's like everyone's got not just their own strength and conditioning coach, but their own nutritionist. They all do, because they know how all the games are faster. Like hockey, they're all faster. You are bigger, faster, stronger, and you need that edge. And without it, you know, the recovery time, you know, there was I'll give you one more recovery. I was talking to these guys that the strength and the conditioning coaches for the hockey players, trying to get them to come out of the closet and test, say, let us use their picture and, you know, say something nice. But I finally talked to these guys after a year. And I go, so what's a memorable story? Because they were all just using greens because they didn't understand the hydrant thing. And they go, I go, what's a story that happened this year that you think is impressive? Tell me why. And he goes, well, if I tell you, you probably know who did it. You know, so he goes, all right, I'll tell you. He goes, so there was a hockey player who ruptured his spleen while I was playing hockey, which is, for some, a career-ending injury, and others, just a season-ending injury. He was back, he took five of these three times a day. He was taking 15 a day. By the end of the week, within a week, he was back on the ice and scored a goal on his day back. Mm-hmm. That's how your body can heal if it's given the right things. You already know that from seeing Dr. Gorman, you know, if you're an athlete or just, you know, just get back to work or just feeling better, is that when you combine all these different things, the nutrition, clearing out the emotional stuff and getting your nervous system working, I mean, you're unstoppable. So.
Yeah, just to piggyback off. So I am a fitness instructor at a local boarding school.
Okay.
So I get a lot of international students who are kind of on their own to provide their own diet.
Okay.
So a change of location, change of scenery. It's a good dining hall, but, you know, they're used to eating where they're used to eating to, and then now they're transitioning into different sports and things like that. So it's like I'm a perfect storm of, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm doing all this stuff. Everything hurts. I have to study. So it's just trying to. Based on everything you said, it seems like it would make a lot of sense. It's just how do you make that jump from actually getting it to the people? That might be more of a specific kind of conversation.
Well, yeah, we can talk after. You know, you really, it's just a lot. You know, I really wanted to call this the Health Made Simple Path, but I got outvoted by my partners who said that, listen, if you want people to use it, you got to throw that word weight loss in there. You would really give them, you would just say, hey, try it. Try it for 3 days and measure, you know, what the differences are. Especially if you're dealing with athletes, they're going to know, and they're going to want to know. And if it's a boarding school, their parents are going to want to know. They're going to say, well, you might go, what is that? You know, what is that? And what is, how do, you know, and if someone looks it up, they're going to see all kinds of great stuff about it. You know, the best thing is about this in this industry, you know, we don't have to apologize for our products. I mean, it's as clean as you can get. These products cost a lot more money to make, you know, than the average product. You know, when I first went, I'll tell you an industry story. When I first went, deciding to, that the Korea wanted these products. People in Korea heard about molecular hydrogen. They had a product, a hydrogen product. Didn't work as good. They heard about ours. They tried ours. They go, we got to have this product. So we're looking at international, how are we going to set up distribution overseas? And then so my partner had a friend who was the head of distribution for Herbalife. Now, not a healthy company, not a really great product company, but a very good business and business model. Now, these guys did $1.1 billion last quarter, okay? They're humongous, but the products are garbage. If you love Herbalife, I apologize, but the products are garbage. But I met with this guy, and I told him what I was gonna do. He signed NDA, so he can't say anything. And he looked at me, this is what he said. The East Coast guys can appreciate this. Guys, he looks at me, the first words out of his mouth, I don't even know the guy. And he goes, you're an effing idiot. That's what that was the first piece of advice. He goes, I told him what we're going to do. And he goes, first of all, because you look at the shakes and the grease, look at all the stuff, he goes, people are stupid. They don't care. He goes, you care. They don't care. And I go, well, you know, Whole Foods did $11 billion. He goes, it's nothing. In your lifetime, most everybody will still think it's a fad. And this was the piece of advice we got. So needless to say, we did not use any of their recommendations for anything because, you know, it, and fortunately, that's how a lot of people believe and think. You know, my neighbor was the, used to play for the LA Galaxy. It's a soccer team like in LA, and on their jersey, it says Herbalife right on the jersey. I go, I gotta ask you, man. I go, how'd they get their name on your jersey? And he's like, they pay for it. Yeah. I go, is there one person that takes their products on your team? He goes, no, not one. They actually had recovery. I gave the recovery in the locker room, but they had to take the label off so that no one would ever see anything. And, yeah, they cut a $5 million check just to get a name on a shirt. They said they would even build them their own organic labs and everything. So even though they wouldn't do it for everyone else, oh, we'll do it for here, for you guys. So, you know... I don't say that to, you know, it's our mentors always said it's easier to light a, it's better to light a candle than curse the darkness, but every now and then we got to take a peek at, oh yeah, you know, there's a lot of crap out there. So helps us appreciate what we have. So, how are we doing? I don't even know what time it is. My watch is on the wrong time. Okay, so any last burning questions? And then I really didn't do a demo. Does anybody want me to know anything? I mean, I'd be happy. Is any yes?
I'm not sure what I'm going to ask, but I'm going to try.
Okay, go for it.
How will you know?
Yeah.
With the products that you have now, if somebody else is going to try and pour it in on what you have produced. And we don't know that. Whether it's legitimate.
So, well, first of all, there are people that are always trying to do it. Mm-hmm. Second of all, it's hard for me even to do it. I'm going to explain what that means. When you manufacture somewhere, you actually need to have what's called backup manufacturing, except God forbid, the place you get manufactured at. Something happens there, like it burns down or something else. It is so hard to reproduce that shake, no one's done it yet. I've been trying for 3.5 years to find one other person, not just shake, excuse me, the greens, but shake too, definitely the greens. I've been trying for 3.5 years to find one other place to actually make it right and make it taste the same way. Impossible. The place that we get our shake made, I was told that they get calls weekly, you know, because these guys are contract manufacturers for worldwide. And they go, weekly they hear, we need a shake for a company. And they go, what do you have in mind? What would you like to model? And they go, have you heard of a company called 7.2? And they say, no. They're not allowed to say, you know. So it's extremely difficult. There are people, you know, we're first to market with the hydrogen. There are other companies trying to make it, but there's one company trying that looks like they're infringing on the patent, but that's what lawyers are there for, you know what I mean? And the alkaline booster is even tough to copy. There are other similar products out there, but the number one reason most people won't spend the money, they'd rather have the margins. So, yeah, not quite pharmaceutical margins, but hopefully that helps. Yes?
Can you talk more about it, you know, for weight loss? Would that be just using the shakes, and would it work as a detox, you know, first, and what would that be like? And
well, the greens have a mild detoxifying effect. It's not like a full-blown cleanse, let's say, and that's on purpose. You know, we store a lot of the toxic things in our body in fat and fat cells. So as we emulsify that, those things are released. So obviously we want to drink a lot of water when we're doing this kind of stuff, if that's what it is. You know, it works both ways. I mean, there are people that are what we call, you know, ectomorphs, where they're like, you're crying because they can't put 2 pounds on, you know, we all know them, they have our friends who have a metabolism like a cheetah, you know, right, doesn't matter, so they go out to the claim jumper and eat the Widowmaker burger and 3 orders of fries and a milkshake, and swear to God, I'm doing that, watching that happen forever, and then put a pound on, so, when you do this, you'll actually increase your lean body mass, so they actually can a little bit, you know. And if you're really lean, don't think you're going to get super skinny by taking it. It's not a weight loss program. It is a health right program. And if weight is excess, like we do a muscle testing test, I'll test people, like I'll have them, I say grab some weight you don't want, you know, so they'll grab something, right? And then it'll weaken a muscle on them because their brain is registering it as something that's not supposed to be there. Then either I'll have them taste or hold each product to see if it's offsetting that, if that's their primary goal. If something doesn't offset it, then I won't put them on that one product, you know? And so it helps us, you know, test that. I mean, we can test you or you can test somebody, you know, it doesn't matter. It's a very simple test. And then I also like to see, will it offset like certain circuits or acupuncture points or meridians for, let's say, the thyroid or pituitary or your adrenals or, you know, certain endocrine glands that have to do when people have a hard time, you know, burning the fat, so to speak.
Demo time.
Okay, demo time. On you or
is
What do you got going on?
What you just said.
Okay. All right, so I'll tell you what. We'll do a couple of quick demos. And what's your name?
Valerie.
All right, come on up here, Valerie. Valerie, this is everyone. Everyone, Valerie. Okay, so are you a patient here? Have you been here before?
Yeah.
Okay, great. And do you have any other health issues that are a concern or anything that lingers? Anything the good doctor continues to work with? I know you say you had some weight you don't want, right?
Yep.
Okay, but that's the primary.
I've been doing the ideal protein, which has helped tremendously.
Great.
So this sounds great, and I know about the alkaline environment kind of thing, and I think that's really cool.
Great.
So.
Awesome. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. So here's what I say when we do our demo. So we're gonna use your body like a computer, your muscles like a keyboard. We're gonna access information. Now it's look like I'm gonna test to see how strong you are. I'm not. I'm just testing to see if a muscle's working.
Okay.
And then we're gonna do a test to see if there is excess weight that's not supposed to be there, and then we're gonna see why. Fair enough?
Yep.
Okay. So let's use a simple, easy test that you see people do all the time. It's called an anterior deltoid test. I'm going to try and push down. I want you to hold it up. Okay, it's not me against you. I just want to see you can hold it. So that's strong. So it's not like me against you, like, come on. I just want to see that you can hold it.
Right.
Okay. Now, you have spots all over your body. They're called acupuncture points and meridian points. They tell us what's going on the inside. Now, you can let that rest for a second. Your body's mostly water. Water conducts electricity. If I touch a spot and there's no flow there, or flow is diminished, it's going to weaken your arm. God forbid if you were getting electrocuted and I touched you, I would get electrocuted too, because we're all water, okay? So that's how this works, even though this is going to look like magic. But every human being has one spot on their body that should be weak. So we're going to test that on you, okay? So hold this up. Okay, that's strong. I want you to take one hand and touch the bridge of your nose right here, okay? Now hold this up. See how it starts to get weak? So there's nothing wrong with the bridge of your nose. Everyone goes weak there unless they're schizophrenic or on lots of psychotropic drugs. So that's a good start for us.
Okay. Isn't it?
Okay. So you can do this test on your friends at home. They're all going to go weak. If they don't go weak,
run.
Okay. So let me do a couple of tests just to add to the program. So I'm going to touch different spots that are related to things, the parts of your body that are supposed to work to get this physique the way you say you want it, okay? So hold this up again. I'm gonna touch this reflex for your thyroid. Okay, that's okay. This reflex for your pituitary, that's okay. We're gonna touch over here for your liver. That's not a happy spot. Okay, see, it starts to go weak. So it doesn't mean like, what's wrong with my liver? It just means that it's not as good as we'd like it to be, okay? So we're gonna do this little test. So we're just connecting two acupuncture points like this. With your fingers like that, I'm gonna touch the liver again. So one of two things are gonna happen. It's going to still be weak, or it's going to now get strong. If it stays weak, it's our number one issue. If it gets strong, then we got to keep looking. No, it's our number one issue. So now, your liver is on the right side of your body, relates to this muscle here, this pec part of your sternum. Does your shoulder ever bother you?
No.
Good, let's keep it that way. So watch. Turn like this. Keep your elbow straight. Straight. What I want you to do is you're going to pull it this way, and I'm pulling up and out.
Oh, okay.
Go for it. See how that's not working? Like it hit
wow.
You with one finger. I kind of know that because your liver's going to be weak. If your liver's weak, if it's weak, this gets weak. And when this gets weak, either it starts to affect my shoulder or my right. Okay? So in this case, since you're standing, we focused on this part.
Ooh, the right knee? Okay.
Yeah. So does your right knee have an issue?
Well, and plus I had surgery too. Though.
That would be an issue. You know, people don't have headaches because they didn't eat enough fruit off the aspirin tree, right? Okay. So, okay, you ready?
Oh, I
know you did. I know you did. No, I'm just teasing you. Okay, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we're going to do one more test. Hold this up. Grab some weight you don't want, like pinch something. Got it? See, that goes weak?
Mm-hmm.
So just for the heck of it, I'm going to touch here for your liver, and that gets strong. So in the kinesiology world, we want to see what's going to do it. So what we're focusing on in her, it's not like I have a thyroid problem. It's not any of that. It's like her liver's not efficiently probably detoxifying her system, so it's probably storing its fat. That's one of the issues. So we look and see everything, even things we think are good. You know, who knows? Sometimes we're taking good stuff, but there's some allergen in it, even something good. I did a video. You can watch it on YouTube. It's called The Five Things You Should Never Have in Your Shake. The top 10 selling shakes that represent tens of billions of dollars all have allergens in it that affect people, and they all swear it's helped them. So there's it's very important. Okay? So let's see. So here's what we do. Now, normally, the proper kinesiology way is you open up a capsule, put it on your tongue, you taste it, sends messages you bring back down to your body. But because our body is frequency generated, we could also, even though it goes right through the plastic, you could hold something. If your body pick up the frequency of what it is, even though this looks like magic, okay? Here's what we're going to do. So I want you to hold this in this hand. I want you to turn this. Remember, this thing was weak. I want you to pull towards that knee. See, it's strong as a rock. Watch, take this one out. Okay, hold this. Do it again. See, even with one finger. So, I know it sucks, right? So, you gotta carry this around all day. It just tells us that, you know, this is something that would help that. Does that make sense? And we would do it with each and every one. Does that make sense? Okay, good. All right, you're a big hand. She did great. Okay, so a couple things. So I'll hang out. We'll hang out if people have certain questions. We're going to take like a five-ish minute break.
Brief samples.
Great. Then we have samples for you to try. If you have to go to the bathroom, mm-hmm. there's a couple of them.
There's two, actually.
There's two bathrooms, which is good. And, you know, I'll be here if anybody wants to ask anything one-on-one. Also, a couple of people had asked who have been trying these products, using this product, interested in, okay, how do I partake? How do I help spread the brand in this community and on the East Coast United States and wherever you know people? You know, because I hear that there's a financial part to understanding and partaking that. If you have any interest in that, you can hang out, because with me, who also came out with me for our event tomorrow is Jessica Albuquerque, who's not only the office manager for the Cohn Health Institute, but is also works with 7.2 to help spread this brand worldwide. She's helped get products into and train the staffs of over 300 doctors' offices, from medical doctors to osteopaths, chiropractors, physical therapists, personal trainers around the world, on how to use these products, how to implement them, as well as hundreds of other people and who love these products and want to help spread the brand. So she's going to hang out and go over exactly how that's done. So not so much the health part, but more the how do I do that part. Okay, so after the break, right? Break, and then okay, and yes, we have products for available. Because here's the reality: if you're not taking these products, you haven't tried these products, we've all wasted each other's time if you go home without 7.2, without the experience of it. Because it's really about getting these products in your system and seeing what they can do. If I had a moment to spend with each and every one of you, I would show you how you couldn't live without at least one of these things. Because that is all I do all day long, is not just what you see here, but help spread this around the world. Every day I have people in tears about what has happened for themselves, their family, their loved ones. We have people now that were never even took a nutritional product, now work with 7.2 and help bring it around the world. So it's neat to see that transformation happen for so many different people. And it's that you don't know what you don't know until you find out you didn't know it. So we have products here. The staff of this phenomenal Gorman staff who I've met here, who you all know, will be happy to get you whatever you need. Jessica in the back, who you'll see in 5 minutes, is waving her hand. So she can answer any questions about pricing and other stuff, and also how to get the products for a wholesale amount. Okay? All right? Good. Break. Try some product if you haven't. Good.